Hi, my name is Mr.Donkov, and in this video I'll share with you the experience I had on my first serious motorcycling trip. I returned just like 3 days ago, it is all still fresh, and I went through a part of Italy and I used a very small motorcycle, only a 50cc scooter. It was interesting and I learned some new things which I want to share with you. So if you're interested, please stay and enjoy the video. In my past, I used to make some bicycle trips, but I have some issues with my left knee and I want to travel faster and further. So for this trip, I used a small scooter motorbike, which is only 50cc, 49 to be exact. And the reason for this is that here in Europe and also in my country, Slovenia, I cannot use a bigger bike before I make a special motorcycle exam and get a license. So, because this year there was also Corona and things were closed down and I could not finish the exam in time, so I decided to just use what I got and go like that. This motorbike is a Sim Orbit 2, which I bought used because I didn't know if I really like motorcycling that much. So before making any exams or buying a bigger bike, I just purchased this one to try it out, if I even like it. And when I got it, it had a bit over 10,000 kilometers, which is about 6,300 miles. And also before doing any travel, I took the bike to the service shop, so everything was checked, some things were replaced, and the bike was ready for the travels I would make. Anyway, I know some people from church here in my city, Ljubljana. They're American missionaries and they recently moved to Marseille, France. I was still in contact with them and I made a deal to come visit, say hello and also to have a good excuse to travel, to have some goal to go somewhere. First I planned to go all the way to Marseille with a motorbike, but this is like 1,300 kilometers one way and a lot of mountains, especially in France, so I thought this would be a bit too dangerous for such small bike and my speed would be very low, as well as I could have some engine issues on such a long trip. So I just set my goal toward Torino, Italy, which is about 700 kilometers from where I live, and it is mostly flat to get there. It is also the northern part of Italy, the roads are good. And my plan was then to leave the motor there somewhere, stay a couple of days, and then take the Flixbus to Marseille. I packed everything and prepared. I decided to travel as light as possible because I often made the mistake of taking too many things with me. So for this travel, I wanted to pack as minimal as possible and travel as light and as comfortably as possible. If you want to see the video, what I take with me, check the link below this video. The link will take you to my packing system video, and there is also a present for you, which you can use on your future travels. First part of the road was to go from Ljubljana to Italy, and the first 100 kilometers I drove through Slovenia, which is a very nice country. Honestly, when I started, I wasn't even sure if I really wanted to make this trip. I was a bit afraid, and it was also very much out of the ordinary for me. So I decided just to start to do a 1 day ride, and then I will see how I feel about it and how it goes. But very soon as I started, like the first hour of my ride, I really enjoyed the trip, so I just kind of decided I will really do this. And as I started to travel, I also got in touch with a friend of mine. Actually, we used to be a couple for some time, and now she's my dear friend from Berlin, Germany. And I knew that she lived in Torino for a while because she was studying there. So I made contact with her and I asked her what are some nice things to see there. But as it turned out, she was just at this time also going to Italy, but to Florence to visit a friend of hers. And she said if I wanted to come along, if I wanted to visit, I would also have a place to stay there. So this really seemed like almost like an interesting coincidence. And I decided, yeah, to do this. It seemed also like a better option. I would be very happy to see her after some time. And also I would have a place to stay there, have some company, and I could just as well go from there to Marseille. Torino was just my first idea, but really it was not that important. So the first day, I really had a long ride. I was planning to get to some camping area, but it was then too far for one day. So just like 1 hour or two before the sunset, I started to look for a place to put my tent, just anywhere. And this was a bit of a problem because before the town of Aviano, for example, there were a lot of places I could camp, but later it was really a problem to find an empty place. There were farms and fields everywhere, smaller and bigger towns, but eventually I sneaked myself into some forest area and I was lucky to find a secluded space to do some rest. But I'm still not used to sleeping in a tent. There's so many noises, you can hear everything. And there was also some bigger animal or animals right near me in the forest in the night. I could hear like some loud poofing sound, like and sound cracking of the branches. So I was a bit afraid and nervous, and I really couldn't sleep very much this night. But at least I had a big pepper spray with me, so I could at least protect myself if I had to. And I also had a small knife, which gave me a little bit more of peace of mind.
Okay, this is my 50cc scooter. Sim Orbit 50 that I used for this trip. As you can see, I have tent and a sleeping bag and sleeping mat inside and pillow. Then I have all my personal belongings and clothes in here and a little bit of food just for one day. And I'm ready for another day of travel.
And next day I woke up really early in the morning. It was chilly and there were some dark clouds, so I just packed really quick and headed down south toward Florence. And I was happy about my decision to go there because the weather also was much better down there than in the north where I was supposed to go. And next day, I had a really long ride to Florence. I made more than 300 kilometers, which is a lot for one day on such a small bike. And not only that, I also had to cross the mountains where it was very slow and it took me a lot of time. So the last 30 to 50 kilometers, I was starting to get very exhausted and I knew it was not safe anymore, but I had to arrive there. And also the night was approaching, so. And inside I was like feeling like shaking inside, and the road at the end had a lot of traffic and it was very slippery and difficult, but somehow I made it. So for the next few days I spent in Florence, having some good company, going around Florence, doing some sightseeing. And I also got to dance with Mila, who is a very good dancer as well. And here is just a short video of us dancing to some 50s rockabilly jive. So what was next is to go from Florence to Marseille, and I took a Flixbus to visit my American friends. I did a lot of sightseeing also in Marseille, which is quite a nice city, especially the surrounding area. It's good also for walking and bicycling, but overall it is quite much dirtier than my country, Slovenia, for example, which is very clean. And there is also a huge mix of people there, and there were some moments where I didn't feel so much safe. Anyway, I stayed there for a week And then I took the bus back again to Florence and to head back home. And on my way back home, I also stopped in Venice, which is a very beautiful place with a lot of things to see. Anyway, the motorcycle, as I said, is a 2010 Sim Orbit 2, and I was not so sure how it would do on such a long trip. But on the other hand, this is an Asian motor from Taiwan, I think, and I thought if it's good enough for Asia, it's probably good enough for European roads, which are much better, probably. And even if I drove full throttle almost all the time, I knew that the engine is electronically limited, so it shouldn't hurt the engine. And even when I went downhill, the motor just wouldn't allow going above 50 km speed limit, except if there was really, really steep downhill, but I didn't push it there either. I was more worried about possibly overheating the engine in the mountains going uphill, because the engine is only air-cooled. And also there's no signal that the engine is overheating, so I just wouldn't know. And this is why I didn't push the motorcycle too much. And also I did some short breaks here and there. And the other bigger issue could be puncturing the tire, because I had no experience with changing motorcycle tires. I can change a bicycle tire like in 15 minutes, but motor no. I could always still call a towing service to get my bike fixed at some motor shop. But this would be, of course, more expensive. However, luckily I had no tire puncture all my way. The risk was also with the tires, because I was so slow on the road, I always had to keep to the outside of the road. And the problem with this is that there is a lot of debris, a lot of glass and other trash, which gets pushed out to the side of the road. So I really had to be alert to avoid any glass or something that could give me a puncture. As far as packing is concerned, I had all my clothes, a laptop, and some personal belongings in a 70-liter rucksack. And as I weighed it, it had a good 13 kilos. Then there is a back top hard case. And inside I have a tent, inflatable sleeping mat, a good sleeping bag, and an inflatable pillow. The weight of all of this should be about 7 kilos. 2 kilos the case and 5 kilos all the rest, which should not be too much. Even though the manufacturer states to not put more than 5 kilos on the back, but I think it was still safe.
Quick travel tip. When you travel, it's always good to have a small solar charger with you, which you can attach to your luggage, make it secure. And have a extra battery for the phone, and it's always charged just in case you run out of battery. So this is what I recommend doing as well.
And I also added a speaker to my motor. This is a mini rig speaker. It is British and it is very good. I could take two and have a stereo sound, but I just took one to keep the weight down, because they're quite heavy. And I used this stick-on system to attach it, and it was holding really well. And it was really great to have some music from time to time. Either I put on the radio or I put on some of my own music. And at one time I had put the Crandall's Clearwater songs, and it was really great to ride like this. And I felt almost like in a movie. It was almost like a cliché. So, now I will share a couple of things with you which I learned also along the way. And I will start with the most important one, which is safety. I must say that I nearly made an accident once, and it was when I was recording myself riding the motorcycle. As I went back to pick up the phone, so here this is the video, that car came right after me. And I didn't look enough, and I was riding, and when I went back, I just stopped suddenly to turn my bike, but in the last moment I saw that there is a car right behind me. And it was a big mistake that I did, and I didn't look, and the driver nearly crashed me and was also screaming like crazy at me, which is understandable. So I was really lucky not to get in a crash. So the most important lesson is this, that on a motorcycle you really have to always check and to look behind, especially with a small motorcycle like this, because a car can just appear in a moment. And so never make any sudden major changes, stops or whatever, before looking first back and to check if it's really okay. And I did this mistake like 3 times, but this one was really the worst, and almost I had a crash. Because the problem is also that the engine makes sounds, and really you cannot hear what's going on behind you, and also the helmet blocks some sound. Another lesson on a motorcycle is to never hurry, just go normal, just go, take it easy and take it slow, enjoy, and it should be all well. Never hurry, don't hurry on a motorcycle, it makes no sense. And another lesson for me was to navigate the maps, because Google kept sending me to high-speed roads where there was a lot of traffic. I disabled the highways, but there were still big roads which are more dangerous, and there's also many more big trucks. So what I did this was I started to put smaller stops to my trip. I added small cities or villages in between, so it would take me to a smaller roads, not keep me on a big road, at least with a slow bike like this. And the smaller local roads are also much more fun, beautiful scenery and interesting to ride. It's easier. So, to conclude, thank you for watching this video. I hope you liked it and you learned something new. If you did, I invite you to please click like, and I also invite you to subscribe to future videos, because I make many different things, different content. And also below this video you'll find a link to my other video, which is about packing, and there I explain my packing video, how I pack for the travel, and also you'll find a free resource there which will help you for your travels. So again, thank you very much for your time, for watching. Enjoy your day and happy trips, either with a motorcycle, bicycle or whatever. Bye. Tintarella color latte, tutta notte sopra il tetto con i gatti, e se c'è la luna piena, tu diventi candida. Tintarella di luna, tintarella color latte, che fa bianca la tua pelle, ti fa bella tra le belle. E se c'è la luna piena, tu diventi candida.